Looking for authentic Italian food? We found just the place in New Smyrna Beach. Up next on Savored Secrets. Hello and welcome to Savored Secrets. I'm Chef Costa Magoulas. Together, let's explore Bello Valentino's. Man, what a great name. An authentic Italian eatery. Now listen, this is a live show. If you have any questions for us, give us a call at 1-800-901-9238. Get your phone and take the picture and write it down. We went to Bello Valentino's and met with one of the owners, Paola Triani. And guess what? Let's see what they had to say.
Hi, my name is Paola Triani, and welcome to Bello Valentino. We're starting our 20th year. We've been here 19 years. We're starting our 20th year. And we have my husband in the kitchen, which he's the chef. I'm outside in the dining room. I take care of the people. I hostess the people that will come in. And then we have my mom that she does all the pastries and desserts for us. We come from a family of bakeries from Europe and from New York. This is, we call it the family wall, because we have pictures here of our family, but also the people that worked for us, all their family, and people that have worked here, and also people that are important, like on that side, that have come into our restaurant. And this means a lot to us because it's our family wall. Our girls, we've had our girls here also for 20 years. They've been with us that long, and we try to accommodate and take care of everybody that walks into this place.
Hi, I'm Amy. This is Connie.
Hi.
We have been working at Bello Valentino's for 20 plus years, I think.
Yes.
It's been a while. We are like best friends. and we have many customers that come in. They ask for Connie or myself or any of our other colleagues. We love our customers. We love serving you.
We're like a big family around here.
Yep. I love all my customers that come and join us here at the restaurant. I feel like over the years, I've become so close to them that we're all so friends. And every time they come, I always want to make sure that they're happy and I'll do whatever I have to. And they know that, but the people here that come here are wonderful, and I've had them for customers for so many years.
We need you to come in and see us, try our food, get wonderful service so we can get to know you.
Well, hi, I'd like to introduce our guest this evening, Chef Maurice. Come on down.
How are you, Chef?
Good to see you,
partner. I'll eat it soon. Good to see you.
I see you made this lovely chicken dish, and you brought it here. So we took some pictures, so let's take a look at you cooking it in action, okay?
Yes, yes. It's a pan here with olive oil. You dust the chicken breast into the flour. You slice the chicken very thin. You pound it out, and dust it to the flour, and then you saute until it gets to golden brown. And we get it in the pan. Start making the sauce for the chicken. Put butter, white wine, chicken stock, sage, wild mushrooms, a little salt, and we're gonna stuff it with provolone, prosciutto, and spinach. Then we're gonna use some mixture of cheese. And then we're gonna bake it right into the salamander. few minutes in the salamander until it gets nice and cold. Make people feel good, taste good. I love cooking. I love food in general. And I like to make people happy of when they enjoy eating. Our chicken is ready. Put it one more time in a burner. And then we serve it on our plate. So our chicken. A little parsley, fresh parsley. It's chicken Isabella.
Well, let's see what you made here, okay? This thing's beautiful. Tell me about it.
Yes, it's chicken Isabella.
What a beautiful dish.
It's sauteed breast with the spinach prosciutto and provolone cheese.
Prosciutto, is
that right? Yes, yes. And a combination of a mixed tricolor cheese.
What kind of dessert did you make?
This is a pistachio cheesecake.
Better hide that from my wife, okay?
Yes, yes.
I tell you what, your food looks fantastic. Let's just chit-chat a little bit about the restaurant and everything. To start with, I'm going to be cooking a few things at the same time. We need to cook something to honor you being okay. here, okay? So, but you were telling me originally, I thought you're Italian, right?
Yes, I'm Sicilian.
You are from, oh, you're from Sicily?
Yes.
You were born there?
I was born there.
Wow.
I came here when I was 10 years old.
You're the real deal.
Yes, yes.
So were you in the kitchen all the time?
Yes, since I was 10 years old, I started cooking. I learned from my mom. Which they come from the family members, that they're all chefs. So I have cousins in New York
surprise,
that have restaurants.
Surprise, right?
Yeah, I have restaurants in Europe as well, too.
Really?
Yes.
What made you come to Florida?
My mom's sister was already here. So
oh,
she
that's
told
nice.
Us, come to Florida, the sun is great.
I've got to ask you, Bello Valentino, what a great name. Why?
I always liked it in a restaurant in Italy when I was little, and I loved the name Valentino.
Yeah.
So that's what I named after Bello.
Because I'm thinking, man, there's got to be some kind of mystic answer to that or something. Does Bello mean beautiful or
yes,
great?
Yes, it means beautiful in Italian.
And Valentino, does that
Valentino's a, like Rudolph Valentino.
So it's a place, lovely place.
Oh, yes.
Yeah, I get what you're going.
Yes.
Couples and stuff like
yes.
that.
Yes.
Yeah, you hit right on the bed.
Yeah.
You know, I could tell you do scratch cooking, which means you're probably in the kitchen forever, okay?
Always.
Yeah. What time you go in the morning?
I usually go in around like 10 o'clock.
Yeah, but you're there till...
Until 10 o'clock at night, 11
Gee,
o'clock at night.
Gee, that's only 12 hours.
Yeah.
Well, listen, we're going to keep talking about the restaurant. I have a couple things cooking here. Now, Greeks do pasta, okay? But we don't do it like you do.
Okay.
I like your pasta, okay? And that white sauce that you made, oh, my goodness. I could take that into a jar and just drink it.
The Alfredo sauce?
Oh, that was... Unbelievable.
We made also gorgonzola, which is similar to a
Alfredo sauce. Is it really?
Sauce. Yes.
Thank you. I saw that earlier, and I was going, guys, stay away from this, okay? Because after the show, everybody gets a chance to taste everything.
Of course.
I will set that aside, okay?
Definitely.
What I was going to do for you tonight, they have an island called Hadki, okay? And they're, you know, country people, and they like pasta. But a friend of mine said the way they eat it is they burn onions.
Okay.
And they mix it in with the pasta. I said, okay, so that's what I'm doing. I'm burning some onions over here, okay?
Sounds good.
And smells pretty good. It's
yes.
got butter on it and everything else. I don't know if you can see that. It is actually dark, see? It's not crispy brown. Chef's
yep.
going, okay.
Yep.
And then we're also going to do a, we made a regular, it's just a regular tomato sauce. Taste it, no comment, just, you know. But we made the little rolled meat. How do you pronounce it?
Brujol.
Is it brujol or brujole?
Brujole, if you want to call it.
Yeah, because I've heard that.
Yes.
I wanted to say it right when you were here.
Yeah.
Let me ask you, when you came over, did you speak English at all?
No. Not at all. I went straight to school.
Did you really?
Yes.
You know, I was raised in a Greek family, and I didn't speak English either. I had to go to American school to
right.
speak English. But I got to tell everybody a secret here, okay, gang? I went and had a DNA test done, and I've got almost 50% Italian genes in me,
oh,
okay?
Wow. Well, Sicily is 50% half Greek.
Well, there you go. So where's half and half? I love it. Okay. Well, we're going to get going over here and cook a little bit. I want to turn the heat up on this thing. All I did was brown some onions in butter.
Okay.
Nothing special, you know. Do you cater at the restaurant?
Yes.
Do parties, special parties, or?
Yes, we do special parties as well, too. Weddings, receptions.
So you do the actual reception and everything?
Yes.
Oh, wow, that's a lot.
Yes, okay. We do.
You have beverage at the restaurant,
right? Beer and wine.
Beer and wine. Any specialty? Is it just all kinds of
all
wine?
Kinds? Mixture of California, house, Italian, French.
Do you?
Yes.
Yeah, you know, that's one thing. I did visit Italy. I didn't drink any bad wines anywhere. And it seemed like everybody had their own wine.
Yes.
They had kegs out back.
They make their own wine.
Do you do that at all?
I don't do that, but I know somebody that does.
Yeah, I got to figure that. Yeah. That is popular, wine and things, especially when you're eating Italian food. A lot of people think of pasta.
Okay. Correct.
But I know that's not the key thing here. Your menu... Tell me something about your menu, because I saw so many different things on there. I wanted to try the vegetable roll. I mean, you had
cannellonis.
Oh.
We serve cannelloni. We serve grouper as well, veal, chicken.
Yeah.
We do a lobster. We do a lobster lemon jello.
How do you do the lobster raviolis?
With the lemon jellos. We do lobster lemon jello sauce as well, too.
Lemon jello.
Lemon jello.
Lobster sauce.
Yes.
You guys kidding me?
Yes.
Really?
Yes. We also do grouper drambuie with the drambuie sauce.
Really?
Yes.
My God. Are you ready to go back now?
Yes. Yes.
What a great restaurant.
Thank
anyway,
you.
Folks, I got these onions going nuts over here. And as you can see, they're kind of dark.
Yes.
and then what we do is we add some pasta to it. Do you have any preference on pastas?
It depends what you like. I actually like the big pastas.
The big one.
Yes.
I was going to bring it tonight. But I was thinking this would probably be easier to cook with these onions.
A lot easier.
And got my gloves on, guys. Okay, relax. I'm going to try and get this in here.
Yep.
This is nothing but onions and butter.
Yes.
And love. I think that's about it.
Usually when you cook the onions, they get very sweet. When they get brown, caramelize them really well.
Yeah. Well, that's what they like, you know. And then, you know, I can sit here and all day long and try to flip it. But with my luck, I'll have it all over the table and everything. So I'm going to try and mix it up a little bit. Just take the onions and you mix it up real good. I'm heating the spaghetti because it wasn't real hot. And I do a little twist on it, okay? They eat it like this, okay? Now, I try to put something on it to make it a little bit more. Let me get this thing over here so I can work on it. Now, don't do this at home, gang, because your hands can't handle it, okay? But I mix this stuff up in here really good. See the onions are going, oh. It's not that white sauce, so
no.
I'm telling you. Now, and you see the caramelized onions in there. Now, to me, it needs more flavor. So I take and get gorgonzola cheese. Now, Chef's laughing over there. He's saying, that's not gorgonzola. He's, that's blue cheese.
Blue cheese.
It's blue cheese. You're right. I couldn't get gorgonzola. People, if you aren't that sure about blue cheese and everything, gorgonzola is Italian. It's a mild blue cheese. It's quite good. I think it has a heartier taste.
Correct.
This is a buttermilk blue cheese.
Right.
So don't get mad at me, okay? I'm going to put that in here and let that cook away a little bit. That's got to add some kind of flavor to it.
Yes, it does.
Maurice, you got to tell me now. You're in New Smyrna Beach, but where? Your
right
location?
On US 1.
Yeah.
Right. We're north of the airport in New Smyrna Beach.
So you go down US 1.
You go
right
down US 1.
And it's on the right hand side.
It's on the right hand side, yes.
It's really easy to see. I got to tell you, I love those lights you have at the front doors.
Yes.
Is that your wife's idea?
Yes, it is.
Yeah, I figured it would be. We wouldn't think of something like that. I said, man, that was kind of clever with the lights on the door. Because you really see the place stands out. It really does. But we had some people call and find out where you're located at.
Okay.
Which is important.
Okay.
Let me tell you, folks, you want to eat some real Italian food. We got some great restaurants in Volusia County, but I got to tell you, this is one of them. I really mean that.
Thank you.
And, just if you want something different, original Italian, that's the real deal. I think it's a real deal anyway. Okay, we got this thing pretty much going here. Well, I didn't do too bad. All right, that dish is kind of set right there. You know what? I forgot to get forks and spoons. I think I have some here. Oh, we got everything here. Chef, I don't want to dig in and mess up your thing, but here, if you want to take and give me a... I want you to try this sauce a little bit. I've only cooked it for 2 days, so I still think it's kind of...
A little hearty?
Well, I think it's still a little acidic.
Yes, definitely is.
Yeah. How long would you cook that?
I would cook it at least an hour or so, but you have to add water to it.
Yeah.
You have to add quite a bit of water to it.
What I was doing is using chicken stock to try to thin it out with and bringing it here to the show. I noticed it thick and dried up on me.
Yes.
So I'm going to use this for the brajole.
Yes.
And then here is this dish. And you know how this is going to taste, but you're more than welcome to give it a try. And don't say anything bad.
I'm not.
But I think that cheese really makes it. You notice how he does that like an Italian. He rolls it on the
floor. I roll it on a spoon.
That's the way you're supposed to do it, folks.
That's excellent.
I was waiting for you to go, oh, that's okay.
That blue cheese goes really well with the caramelized onions.
That, didn't it, though? I was really surprised that.
Yes, very good.
So we got a winner on that one. That's good. That's always a good sign.
Yes.
All right, I got to do something here. I'm going to get a, see where I have it here. We're going to do the brajole, and I just want to give you an idea how you make this brajole. And so, you get generally flank steak brajole.
Correct.
And Chef's over there laughing. He's going, that's not flank steak. I cheated, okay? It's a sirloin steak, all right? I wanted it to be special.
Yep.
Plus, it's easier to cook.
Okay? Yep.
Flank steaks are rather tough, so you have to kind of really beat them out, right?
Correct.
But I take this thing here.
And pound it out.
And you flatten it out. Isn't that wonderful?
Yes.
You get it nice and flat if you can. And what I do is I like to use prosciutto. Prosciutto.
Prosciutto.
Prosciutto. He says it better than I do. Oh, I love this stuff. And I take the olives.
Kalamata olives.
Kalamata olives. Those are good, aren't they?
They're the best.
Put some of that in there. You know, I got to do it Greek style, okay?
Yes.
So I said feta cheese.
A little feta cheese.
And I put that in there. Now, I do something a little bit different. See if I flattened this out enough, or maybe I didn't. You roll it up like that, and they generally tie it, right?
Correct.
Well, I cheat, and I use skewers.
Skewers.
Doing it quick so that way.
Yep. But there's also another way you can make that as well, too.
Cooking it.
You could use parchment paper, roll it, and then roll it with aluminum foil.
Ooh,
and put them
I
in
like
the water
that.
Inside of the oven, and you can cook them like that as well.
Really?
Yes.
See, you learn everything on this show. And that's how it comes out. Then what you do is I would brown it a little bit in on the pan here, and then I would finish it in the oven. Do you use marinara sauce or?
Yes,
is that
marinara sauce,
okay.
Yes.
But this is what you start with, okay? But here's what you're going to finish. Evan, where are you at?
I'm right here. Hi, Maurice.
Come on.
How are you? How you doing?
Good. I saw you over there. You saw that dessert. I can see right now you went running for it, didn't you?
Sneak that off the table here. What do you need?
Listen, what do I need? All kinds of stuff, okay? We have something in the oven. Be careful. Don't burn yourself, okay?
I will not.
Well, it's not that hot. Watch her now. When your back's turned, no telling what she's going to do. Are you all done?
Yes.
Well, wait a minute. I want you to see what you brought in.
Smells good.
It sure does.
Oops. Oh, yes. The magic oven.
Yes.
The magic oven did it again. Here, can you grab that foil, hon?
Sure.
See, she's... okay, in the kitchen.
Yeah.
Now, there's some of that sauce we were looking for that would... Oh, that looks good. Anyway, there's the brujol. Brujoli or brujol.
Yeah.
Again, I cheated. It is not flank. He's looking at it. He says, that's not flank steak. I said, no, it's a steak. Okay, I get it. Okay. We're going to...
They look real good.
What we're going to do is take it over here. We're going to cut it up. Everybody's going to get a taste, okay? Don't go running up here real quick. You're going to have to watch out after the show. It gets really hectic here. Now, I have the scissors here to cut the string because you don't want to eat that, I guess. You do tie yours, don't you?
Yes. Okay.
Don't forget, folks, this is a call-in show, 1-800-901-9238. You're more than welcome. Ask Marie some questions, man. Let me tell you, he just taught me two or three things already. All right, get all the string out of here. And we put this over here. And we take this. Now, you wouldn't serve this whole thing. He probably would. Well, that doesn't look too bad.
It looks real good, actually. It's cutting really well.
Oh, isn't that though?
Yes, it is.
I didn't want to take any chances.
No, it's cutting really well.
Helen from Gainesville, Florida. What's on your mind, Helen?
Hey, Chef. How are you?
I'm fantastic.
You've got a great chef. So much respect for you. I just love you, Shell.
Thank you.
I just have a question here about cheese in general. Is it better to use it if it's grated cheese or block cheese when you're making a recipe, or is there a difference?
I'm not quite sure. Well, I basically, but you get block cheese and we grate it ourselves.
Correct.
Because we want to, I put the rind of the, in this marinara sauce, so you get all that great flavor in there.
Yes.
It really is. Hope that answers your question. These are Greek style string beans. They're just olive oil and, you know, and a little bit of potato in there.
Potatoes in there.
And then try to clean this dish up a little bit. It looks like I destroyed it. And we get this out of your way here. Okay, I understand. So his dish looks better, okay? But we're just trying to feed the masses here, all right?
Yes.
But actually, it looked pretty good.
Actually,
inside.
The brujol looks really good.
Thank you. I really appreciate that.
Yes.
So we were talking about the restaurant because we're kind of getting close on time here. Location's in New Smyrna.
Correct.
And it's on US 1 if you're heading south.
Right.
I don't know. If in New Smyrna, probably everybody knows where it's at.
Okay.
And it's not that long a drive either. I mean, I love it. I think it's great. What days are you open?
We're open from Tuesday to Saturdays, closed Sunday, Monday, 4:30 to 9:30.
Closed Sunday and Monday.
Closed Sunday
and
Monday.
Fantastic.
Yes.
You know, a lot of restaurants are doing that. You know, it's better for the staff and everybody else.
Correct.
When they're doing things like that. When you start, you know, working 7 days a week, you can't keep staff or, and your hours are...
4:30 to 9:30.
See, that's decent.
Yes.
That's pretty. At least she can put up with you for a while.
Yes, I can.
But you're in the kitchen probably most
Correct.
Of the time. She doesn't see y'all.
Correct.
Do you go back to Italy on vacation?
Actually, I was there last year in the summertime.
Well, I'd like to thank you all for joining us. Thank you, Maurice, for coming out here and sharing your cooking with us and giving us another look at a hidden gem for those at home looking to try something new. You didn't get your questions answered? You can email us at wdsctv@daytonastate.edu. And don't forget, check us out on social media. People mess up on that. They don't go on social media. You can get, YouTube and all that. You can see us again and again and again. I know I go home and watch it. My wife says, "What are you doing?" "Well, I want to see how you looked on it." She says, "That's a lie." She really has fun with that. But anyway, social media, ask questions, send some emails. We really will be happy to answer the emails. You have any closing things you want to tell us about the restaurant real quick?
Just try us out and everything is homemade.
It is homemade. It really is, okay? Don't forget, join us next time for more Savored Secrets, okay? This show is coming to you so you can enjoy it.
All right.